birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Tammy Dayer. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Tammy. Mwah. A memory? Oh, I could give many memories, but one of my favorite is the day that you were born. I stood outside of Fairmont General Hospital because Dad was not allowed to go in, and jumped up and down, up and down, up and down, because my sister was having a baby and I couldn't wait to see her. Another favorite memory is my mother said, she doesn't look anything like Carolyn. You had no hair. And other favorite memories were when you were little, you would cross the street without your mom knowing where you were going and come to Grandma's. I could go on and on and on, but my greatest memory is the day you were born. I love you, girl. Mwah.
Happy birthday, Tammy Dare.
Happy birthday, Tammy.
We love you.
Hi. Mwah. From us.
Happy birthday, Tammy, and many, 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 many more. And I'm looking forward to seeing you all on the 14th. Yay!
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to Tammy. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
I love you.
Hi, Tammy. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Tammy. We love you and miss you.
60 years old? Don't worry. 60 is the new 40, as I would say. Don't worry. Sure it is.
And he gets a year younger with every birthday he gets.
Right.
For he goes from 40 to 39, so you can do the same thing.
Right.
Just say it runs in the family.
Humorous stories, funny stories when you were growing up. Best one I can remember is when you all lived in Ohio. I don't know if it was Delaware or it wasn't Fulton, because the story is your mom had to go to the bank. This was the good old days. I was just 16. I was learning to drive. And the banks closed at 3 o'clock. She was hurried to go to the bank. You were in the back seat. Got to the bank. It was right on the main drag. And there was, like I say, this was the good old days. There was no drive-through bank. So there was no place to park. She says, Bill, just go around the block. I'll just be in there a minute. Pick me up. I said, okay. So your mom got out of the car. I slid over. She went in the bank. You were watching. As soon as she were out of your sight, you started screaming and yelling and crying. Okay, well, Tammy, she's all right. We're all right. Went around the block once, came around. No mommy. Went around the block again, came around. No mommy. Long story short, we went around that block four times. You screamed the whole time. I don't know. It took maybe, 10, 12 minutes, but it was a long 10 or 12 minutes. But as soon as you saw your mommy, you quit crying. Carolyn got in the car and said, everything all right? I couldn't rat you out. I said, yeah, everything was fine.
And the only thing I can remember, Tammy, is that you were always, always busy in school, always active. And you were a cheerleader, and you were always out in that front yard flipping and twisting and turning and cheering up and down that block, you and the other girls. But when you lived out in the corner house across from the Methodist church, I used to come and clean for your mom occasionally. And I was there one day cleaning, and I had cleaned everything but the kitchen, I think. And you showed up with some of your friends and had lunch. You'd come from school just for the lunch hour, and you left. So I finished, and I cleaned the kitchen, and I left. Well, I found out the next day that you had left your snake, which I didn't know you had a snake, and I am deathly afraid of snakes, even night crawlers, And I never went back to your mom's to clean again because I didn't know you had a snake. I did see the aquarium, but I didn't look in it.
I remember that snake.
If I had seen that snake laying on the dining room table because you forgot to put it back in the aquarium, you probably wouldn't have an Aunt Diane today.
Huh.
But we did want to call and make sure that you knew we were thinking about you and on this very special occasion for you. So, once again,
happy
birthday, Tammy. We love you.
Love you.
Bye.
Bye.
Happy birthday, Tammy. We hope you have a wonderful, peaceful, and celebratory day for your 60th birthday.
And let's make this the year you come visit us in Williamsburg. We'd love to see you. We miss you a lot.
We love you.
Love you.
Happy birthday. Bye.
Well, happy 60th birthday, Tammy. I always knew you were older than me. I have to come up with a story about you. And the only story I could think of is you used to bring Reesville girls to Mr. Donut, and I always thought it was to see me, but I think you girls just like donuts. Happy birthday, darling.
There you are.
With personality.
Chop.
With personality.
Smile.
With personality.
Charm.
With personality.
Love.
With personality.
And plus you got a brand new.
Spending lots of time with you, and we hope that you have a wonderful birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday,
dear
Tammy.
Happy 60th, Tammy.
Wow,
love
she's
old.
That was Scott in the back.
Happy birthday, Aunt Tammy.
Happy birthday, Aunt Tammy.
Hey, Tammy. This is Dennis. Just want you to know how much the Burnetts love you, and happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Tammy. Happy birthday to you.
And many more. Hi, Tammy. That's happy birthday from the Tiddles. And I just wanted to share some of my memories of you, which, with you being the oldest cousin and me one of the youngest, my memories of you are you coming in to visit Grandma, coming in to visit everybody in West Virginia, and I can always remember just the excitement that everybody would have knowing Tammy's coming in or Aunt Carolyn's coming in or all our cousins from South Carolina. And I can remember, I mean, I guess I would have been 10, 11, or 12, I don't know. I can remember a lot of talk and excitement when you were pregnant for the first time. Because you'd waited so long, and I can remember just a lot of talk and excitement. I can remember meeting Victoria, and then I can remember coming to visit you after you'd had Mary Grace. We were traveling through, and so my memories of you are just as a wonderful mother to your girls, wonderful cousin, and we're just all blessed to be a part of the Ash family, and I hope you have a wonderful birthday. Love you. Bye-bye.
Congratulations on your big day. I'm going to play something from your past that I played at your wedding reception. Thank you.
I said that I love you over and over. Honey, love, it's the truth. Over and over.
Do you suffer from pink eye, red eye, tired eyes, shifty eyes, roving eyes? If so, you need to do what thousands of sufferers, eye care sufferers in West Virginia have done. Come to the Fanzler Auto Repair and Eye Treatment Clinic Surgery Center right away. And let Dr. Fanzler give you a new outlook on life. You won't have to wonder in the mornings what's good about it. You'll know if you come to the Fanzler Eye Care Center. And especially here in July, in June, upcoming, half off the price of any eye surgery if you get a new muffler bearing installed or a radiator flush. And Dr. Fanzler will do all the work personally. Also, June the 3rd, in addition to the normal services at the eye care, at the Fanzler Eye Care Center in Hockenberry Hollow, West Virginia, we are proud to announce the opening of two new Fanzler Auto Repair and Eye Surgery Clinics, one in Watkinsville, Georgia, and one in Jekyll Island, Georgia. And of course, in all those, in addition to the eye care and the auto repair, at the same time, you will also get a splicer, dicer, and a carrot, a recipe book, 100 Ways to Cook with Carrots. Tammy, dear, I hope you have a happy birthday. Love you.
Stop it. Happy birthday, Tammy.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Tammy. Happy birthday to you.
Can't wait to walk with you next year.
Shut up.
Happy birthday, Tammy. I always enjoyed giving you a little grief, acting like you were my older sister. We've had so much fun over the years. Love you so much.
Happy birthday, Tammy!
Hey, Tammy. Happy birthday. I can't believe you're turning 60. Thank you for paving the way, and you can show me how to do it. We love you very much, and just hope you have a wonderful day. But just want to let you know how much you mean to me. And you're the first sister who called me sister. And that's extra special to me that you consider me a sister. You are a great mom and a great wife to my brother and a great sister-in-law. And I just cherish all the times we've had together as family, and you always are ready to lend a helping hand like you did very recently. I appreciate you so much, and I appreciate how much you love our grandkids and our kids, and you're just a really important person in our family. Love you. Happy birthday.
Have to give as long as we both shall live.
Happy birthday. Happy 60th birthday. Not my favorite thing to ever have to be on a video or have my picture taken, so I think you know that means you must be pretty special. I just taped Mark. We're not even going to go there and talk about it. But anyway, you want a memory? You know my favorite memories. Are you coming down to the trailer? Spending a lot of time with us, wearing Grandpa Ash's pants over your Long John pajamas, carrying your cups of tea, sitting on the floor October 16th, 1978, asking me, are you in pain? Are you having a pain? Are you having contractions? While we were getting ready to go out the door to go have Aaron.
I have great memories of you were so friendly with Erin. She was the only one allowed to come up and crawl in bed, wake you up. So glad the time you got to live with Grandma and Grandpa Ash those 2 years while you went to school and make memories with them. We love you, Tammy. Sorry you live so far away. You know West Virginia is always your home. We always have a room here for you. Come anytime. Still going to try to get there to see your place one day. I hope you have the best birthday. I'm especially thankful, Lord, to the Lord that Tammy, you are here with us with all that you've been through. I just pray he continues to bless you and Jim and the kids, and I pray that this is the best birthday you've ever had. Love you. Quote, Aunt Kathy.
Hi, Tammy. Happy birthday. You're not getting older. You're getting better, right? Yeah, I remember I became an uncle when you were born. Kind of young. I was only 5. And I remember at the my mom and dad's house, Grandma Ash's house, they had a little bassinet there in the office. Back in those days, it was the office. And came in, the main door was over in the middle of the house. But anyway, yeah. And you know, some things you don't know if you remember, or because, you know, I was only 5, but or if you just remember people talking about it. But anyway, your dad would say the only thing she does is pee and cry and eat, or pee and sleep and, you know, cry. But I remember being up to high school catching tadpoles. And sure, I don't think it must have been at that time, because I was only 5. I don't think Mom and Dad would let me up there at only 5 years of age. But it seems like maybe when you all came back from Ohio one time, I was up to high school catching tadpoles in a old mud puddle up there. But anyway, I remember coming home and you were there. But yeah, you've always been a good niece, and I love you. Happy birthday, 60 years old. Yeah, that's nothing. I can't remember. I remember when I think of you, you're kind of smart and intelligent. I guess you get that from me, right? I remember when your mom and moved to South Carolina, you stayed back, you and Freddie, and you lived with my mom, you lived with Grandma. And Kathy and I lived, we just got married in 1977, about that same time. We lived in a trailer behind the house. And I remember you coming down and visiting a lot. And I remember that old black car you had, and helping you out with that car. I think it was a Dodge Charger or Dodge something. And I remember when you were in high school, this was before, you know, what I was just talking about. But I remember you being a cheerleader and football games in the fall. I remember on Friday nights you would come home to Grandma's house, which I don't know. Seemed like you should have been coming home to your house. But anyway, I don't know. I can't remember things. But you'd always want a cup of hot tea. You know, you liked your tea, and I would ask you about the football game and who won and all that stuff. But, yeah, I remember you jumping on a pogo stick. Yeah, some good old times. But anyway, love you. Happy birthday. Hope you have many more.
You and I know, Tammy. Can't let him go. The breeze from the bayou keeps murmuring low. Tammy, Tammy, you love him so. When the night is warm, soft and warm, I long for his charms. I'd sing like a violin.
Hey, Aunt Tammy. Happy birthday.
So there are so many memories that I have of you, so many great memories. But I think my favorite memory was last year when you got me and my mom and you tickets to see Sean Mullins at that little place in Athens. Can't remember the name of it, but I'd never done anything like that with you before. And I didn't really know what to expect hanging out, you know, at a concert kind of late night with you, my mom, and something that I was used to but had never done with you guys. And it turned out to be incredible. And I really saw a side of you that I'd never seen before. And it really made me love you even more and bond with you even more. And it was a great night. And I love that memory of us. And I loved getting to see you, see Sean, and you light up with joy seeing him perform. And it was a great night. Anyways, I love you so much. And I hope you have a great birthday. Mwah.
Happy birthday, Aunt Tammy. I love you. I hope you have a great day. I'm really sorry you're a Manchester United fan, and I'm sorry you're not going to be in the Champions League next year, but it's fine, because Tottenham's in the final, and you could always just support us then. So, happy birthday. Have fun not being in the Champions League.
Hi, Tammy.
Hi, Tammy. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Welcome to the exclusive club of the 60-year-olds.
Yes, and I'm bringing up the rear, so I'm right behind you.
We had best of intentions to do this in front of First Broad Street because we thought that would be somewhere that would mean something to you, but the weather had other plans.
Yes, so we are now sitting in the car with an air conditioning on, and we thought it didn't matter where we are. But if we remember, we'll get you a shot of the church.
Yes.
When we get out.
Well, we wish we were there to celebrate with you, so maybe we could have a belated celebration at some point.
Yes. This is, please let us know, because we are willing to take a road trip, and I'm sure we can work something out. We'd love to see you.
Yes, definitely, yeah. Definitely. Heather and I were talking earlier, and I was remembering how we used to go and have bagels and coffee when the kids would go to Mother's Day out. So that was a fond memory, and we would have gone to the bagel place, except it no longer is there. So we thought, well, maybe First Broad Street would be another good spot to wish you happy birthday from.
Yes, and thinking of fond memories, I have many, and it's been almost 30 years since I met you, actually, because we've been here, what, 20? Actually, it's about 25.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yes, 25
yeah.
years.
Yeah.
And one of the memories, as you remember, Tammy, is you saved my little life when I first came here with my kids and you introduced me to Mother's Day Out. And another fond memory amongst many are those many bagel coffee hours. And do you remember your frying pan dinners?
Oh, yes. Those were great fun. Great fun, yes.
And that was with the whole, the killer bees.
Yes.
So here's wishing you from the Kingsport killer bees. We're still going strong here.
Yes. And if it wasn't for you, Tammy, Heather and I would never have become friends. So we owe our friendship to you. And we definitely have to make a plan to have a reunion of the killer bees. I guess the killer bees has expanded a little bit if you take into account people are married and have spouses and now having children. And but we're still as young as ever.
That's right, young and hot.
That's right. And Heather and I want to come and visit or meet up with you somewhere.
So after you've got this message, we will be in touch. And let's plan something, because we keep talking about it. And if we don't plan it, it'll never come to fruition. Well, lots of love to Jim and Mary Grace and Victoria, but where is she, Tori? She's overseas now, isn't she, I think?
So she's off to exotic parts of the world.
Yes.
But we're still here in Kingsport.
That's right. Well, listen, lots of love and many happy returns, Tammy, and from our spouses to you. And we look forward to staying in touch.
Definitely. And happy birthday. Have a wonderful birthday celebration. We love you. We miss you. And as Heather said, hope to see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.
Tammy's in love. Whippoorwill, you and I know. Let him go. The breeze from the bayou keeps murmuring low. Tammy, Tammy, you love him so. When the night is warm, soft and warm, I long for his charms. I'd sing like a violin.
Hey, Tammy. Happy birthday. Wow, this is not my best look. But you're 60, and I'm not. I am moving, but I wanted to take a minute out of my day to tell you, have a happy, happy birthday. Enjoy your sister. Enjoy your family time. And you're just a sister from another mister. And I love ya. Oh, and I'm waiting on my sweater.
Oh, I just had to do another one. How about the time when you lived in Fulton, Ohio, and you went into the dog's house that was your next door neighbor's, and everybody was afraid to get you out because the dog was so mean. And you were sitting in there. Or how about the time when you were in Fulton, Ohio, and I took you and we hid in the grass behind the school from your mom? Oh, was she mad, and she let me know it. But I was really over there looking at some of the young boys that were there playing ball. But we got in trouble because I hid you and she couldn't find us. I'll think of more, I'm sure. Love you.
Happy birthday! We're sorry we can't be with you on your birthday this time, sexy and 60. But we just wanted to say that we love you. Yeah.
Love you.
Bye. Hey, Mom.
Hi, Sammy.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
We were just calling to leave. No, we're just calling. Hi, Mom.
Hi, Sammy.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
We're just leaving you this message to say that we love you.
We're just leaving this message. Just called.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Sammy.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
We love you. Fuck, I did that thing with my eyes again where I closed them like this while I'm talking.
We love you.
Hi, Mom.
Hey, Tammy.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
We just wanted to let you know that we love you and that we're really sorry that we can't be there on your birthday this year. I did this last year, but it's okay. yeah, sexy and 60. We'll see you when we get back in August. Bye.
Bye.
Love you.
Just want to wish you a happy birthday. Love you very much. As do your kids, the fishes are in the tank. You don't look a day over 60. Bye, dear.
Hey, Mom.
I
just want to wish you a happy birthday, and I love you so much.
So, it's me. I'm finishing up this video because I made it so I get to go last. and I'm the baby, and I'm a spoiled brat, and I like to boss you around. I intended on making this video when I looked a lot better, when I looked like I'd had some sleep. I had really good intentions, but nope, this is what you get. But mainly I just wanted to tell you that I love you more than anything in the world, and you mean more to me than I can even put into words. I've looked up to you literally my whole entire life. I'm trying not to cry, because you know I'm a big crybaby. You literally have been like a second mom to me. And then you became like a really good friend to me after I became an adult. And now I'm crying. Anyway, I have looked up to you my whole life, and you've just been a wonderful example of a strong woman. You've always been very opinionated and very strong, very intelligent, but also very caring, very loving, very patient, just an overall good person. And I'm just lucky that I have you as a sister. And I just want you to know that this video, and even though it was a sad attempt at a professional looking video, not very good, was my way of trying to show you and tell you how incredibly loved you are and how well thought of you are, and that you have made a mark on this world and on people's lives, and that you've not gone unnoticed. You're very much a caregiver in so many ways. You have been your whole entire life. Your love language is to do things for people and give to people, and you're just very generous and thoughtful, and you don't put anybody, I mean, you put everybody first. You don't put yourself above anybody. You kind of never have. So just for one day, I wanted you to know that you're very special and that you deserve all the happiness, and I just want you to know that so badly. So I hope that this made you happy. I'm sorry that I cried. I'm sorry that I look like this. Can't believe I didn't even try to look better. But whatever. I love you. And I hope you have the most amazing birthday. And I hope you have many, many, many more to come. Bye. Mwah. Could not have a day that was. He said, aside for his recognition. Orange piece of heart will sing. Thanks to my
while, we were wondering what that last picture was about. That was Heather Land, you know, the comedian that says, I ain't doing it. Did you know that she is coming to Charlotte, North Carolina, June the 19th? And there are going to be some people that don't go see her. Unbelievable. But guess what? Not me. And not you. Because I got us tickets for your birthday to go see Heather Land. So happy birthday. And I'm going to tell you what. I'd rather drive down I-85 blindfolded than miss Heather Land. I ain't doing it.